Thank you all for your kind words. Dear all, today I would like to present you my work, which I have carried out at the Department of Medical Genetics here at the University of Szeged. Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis is a fatal neurodegenerative disease, which is characterized by the loss of lower and upper motor neurons. Symptoms usually begin around the age of 50, and the progression of the disease leads to death in 3 to 5 years from diagnosis. A tenth of the cases show a positive family history, while the other 90% remain sporadic. Up to date, there is no efficient cure known to the condition. In 1993, the first gene in the background of ALS was identified, which is superoxide dismutase 1. Since then, multiple genes have been associated with the disease, such as angiogenin, tRDNA binding protein coding gene, and also a repeat expansion in the C9 open reading frame 72 gene. Some genes are associated with an autosomal dominant hereditary pattern, some are associated with an autosomal recessive hereditary pattern, and also there are X-linked variants. In the slide, only the major ALS genes are shown. To our knowledge, there are more than 100 other genes which may as modifiers or risk factors for developing the disease. Our group has been working on the topic of genetic investigations in Hungarian sporadic ALS patients since 2013 and has published 2 articles in the field. I started working in the group in early 2017 under the supervision of Professor Szél and Cornelia Tripolsky. Last year, we had the opportunity to perform the whole exome sequencing of 21 formerly selected samples. 9 of them were females, the other 12 were males, except for one, all of Hungarian origin. Their mean age at the onset of the disease was 55 years. The chosen samples have been pre-screened manually via Sanger sequencing for the 7 major ALS genes, and neither of them carried any disease-causing mutation in those genes. In the process of evaluation of the data, we have created a bioinformatic panel, which has consisted of 3 gene sets. The first one was major ALS genes, which all have a very well-established relationship with the pathomechanism of the disease. The second one was ALS risk or candidate genes, which have been associated with the disease before, but further investigations are needed to clarify that relationship. And since the symptoms and clinical presentation of ALS usually overlaps with some other neurogenetic and neurodegenerative diseases, we have created a gene set dedicated to those genes which are associated with these other diseases. This other diseases set consisted of 160 genes with which I did most of the filtering for, and I had the task to assess the possible significance of the detected variants with the help of prediction softwares and multiple databases. Data analysis was performed according to best practices in order to identify single nucleotide variants and small insertions and deletions. First of all, we have applied a filtering. Then we excluded all the data which did not match our criteria. Calls per sample with a read depth under 10 or an allele balance under 1/4, interning and synonymous variants, and variants with a populational frequency higher than 1% in the most relevant databases were excluded from further analysis. Variants identified in our patients were manually cross-checked in multiple ALS-specific online databases. The detected variants were considered to be pathogenic if they had been previously described as causative. All potentially causal variants were validated via bidirectional Sanger sequencing. I have designed primers for 70 target regions, which are included in the genes of the other diseases gene set. And after diluting the primers, I have optimized the reactions and evaluated the electrophenograms. After filtering the whole exome sequencing data, 6 priority gene variants in 7 patients, 30 risk or candidate genes gene variants in 17 patients, and 93 other diseases gene variants were identified in all 21 patients. In the priority genes, 6 genes variants were identified, of which 4 have never been associated with the disease before. One of the identified variants, the P G1177X in alsin is proven to be pathogenic and known to cause juvenile onset ALS when found in homozygous form. The other variants are all categorized as variants of uncertain significance, although all prediction tools associate them with a deleterious effect on the protein. In the risk gene set, 2 novel and 28 recurrent rare variants were detected in this study and all classified as variants of uncertain significance. And as far as the other neurogenetic gene set is concerned, a total of 93 variants were identified in the 160 genes that are associated with the other neurogenetic disorders. 6 of them were classified as pathogenic or likely pathogenic variants, while the other 87 were considered as variants of uncertain significance. Among others, non-pathogenic mutations were revealed in the GJB1 gene, which is associated with mitochondria disorders and Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease, and also in the GBE1 gene, novel mutations were found, which are associated with autosomal recessive adult type polyglucosampathy disease. We identified variants in further genes, however, some of them are unlikely to be implicated in our patients' phenotypes. Lastly, I would like to say thank you to my mentors at the Department of Medical Genetics, Professor Marta Sale and Cornelia Tripolsky, and I would like to thank the senior clinicians at the Department of Neurology for the patient recruitment. And last but not least, I would like to thank you for your very kind attention, and I'm happy to answer any upcoming questions.